One of the other treatments or tools that we use in people with stroke and a number of related disorders where we need to treat spasticity or muscle contraction that doesn't relax when it should is the use of Botox, or in the bigger category, which is botulinum toxins. And there's more than one brand, there's more than just Botox. What Botox does is to help us relax a muscle that's too tense, or to use another word, it's dystonic. It's contracting when it should be relaxed. For a stroke patient, this often means that they have trouble getting their heel down on the ground while they're walking. They're stepping with their toe because their calf muscles are too tight, and they're forcing the forefoot down and into a toe walking position. As an example, injecting some Botox into those calf muscles helps to relax them, can help the physical therapist and the exercise program to stretch those muscles out better. It might help us just fit a brace better to stabilize that ankle and get it under better control, or in a better situation might allow somebody with a little more strength to walk without a brace as a result of the Botox treatment. We apply Botox to the legs in many people. We'll also use it in the stroke patient who also has some arm impairment as well as the leg on the same side as a result of the stroke. We use the Botox to free up the movements in the arm. Sometimes this allows improved function where they can better use the hand and use both hands for everyday activities. And in the end, toward our goal for everybody we work with, which is a higher level of independence, the ability to take care of their daily needs, maybe even go back to work, which, as I said, is depends upon the individual's goals. But in general, you know, most people are looking to be independently taking care of themselves and not needing some kind of assistance or caretaker at home in spite of whatever disabling condition they might have.